Get ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lynn Deerfield, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers.
Nice to have you with us. Let's go over and see who we got today. Welcome, one and all. Nice to see all of your bodies again. I've never seen your body, have I?
Yes, you have.
I have?
Yes,
tell
in 1969.
In 1969?
I was a contestant on the Match Debuts.
You were
New
a contestant
York,
on the
I
old...
won.
No, how much did you win?
$450.
No kidding.
That's all they'd give.
And now...
I was the big winner. And Burt Reynolds was my team captain.
Burt Reynolds was your team captain? Mm-hmm. Who else was on that show?
Don Meredith.
Don Meredith?
I didn't know who they were.
And you didn't know who they were?
You weren't alone in 1969.
Well, she's become an actress.
That's right. You're on The Guiding Light, aren't you? And now you're a big star, and here you are back again. You were on that side at one time, and now you're on this side.
Yeah.
We welcome you. We got to welcome you officially, even though I've seen you before.
Oh, I
you're
forgot
kind of
to
the
warn
new
her
kid on
that.
The block.
I know I am.
And the ceremony...
is that you kiss me.
Yeah.
That was the bad news I was telling you about.
Listen, you're wearing a lot of lipstick, aren't you?
It's not my fault. I didn't put it on.
You didn't put it on?
Blame the makeup department.
But don't get me all smeared up. Let's be gentle because, you know, I can't do the show
hell,
with lipstick
you
on.
Go too far.
No, just a sweet.
This is foreplay.
Does that mean two others can get into it?
Yeah.
All right, my dear, here we go. Oh. Let's say hello to our current chap, Mike Eskew, here. Hello, Mike.
Hello.
Mike has won one game. As a matter of fact, he just won the game when we had to quit last time.
Right.
What is that penny doing there?
I found it on the floor.
Oh, there's a dime.
And a dime, too.
Where'd you find it? What floor did you find it on?
Right here.
Right down there, yeah. And what's you got in your hand?
I got that at Vegas.
That's a dollar, a silver dollar?
Silver dollar.
Yeah. Is it a good luck symbol for you?
I don't know. It helped yesterday.
Yeah. Well, I hope it helps today, Mike.
Oh, I hope so.
I hope so, too. Mike's a coal miner from southern Illinois. And I have felt for many years it was a difficult job, and there ought to be another way of doing it instead of sending the men down 10,000 feet into those terrible black holes. But he likes his work. He's a square peg in a square hole, and he's very happy, and we're very happy to have him. Now, we're going to start with a big money super match here, the audience match, where you could win over $5,000. So come right back and see how Mike does with that. Here we are with old Mike Eskew here from southern Illinois. Benton, Illinois, right?
Right.
Okay, Mike, we'll get right to it now. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Lark, L-A-R-K. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it, $250 if you hook up with the middle one, and $100 for the bottom one. Now, three of our celebrities...
right out of the box.
Thank you. Okay, excuse me. I didn't mean to sneeze in your face, but they say if you hold it back, you could hurt yourself. Get a hernia or something like that. Anyway, where are we? Oh, yeah. Now, three of our six celebrities are permitted to assist by giving answers here to you.
Brett.
What about Skylark?
Skylark, that's very nice.
Betty.
Betty.
How about Meadowlark?
Meadowlark.
And Richard.
Mudlark.
Mudlark?
Yes, very.
What is a...
It's a mudlark.
A mudlark is a child that goes in the mud to get coins. A film with Alec Guinness and
really?
Irene Dunne got the Academy Award for playing Queen Victoria. The word mudlark.
More than I care to...
Now, if he doesn't want it, let him find somebody else to give it.
Now, Mike, you got him. You got Mudlark, Meadowlark, and Skylark. Have you got any other ideas in your head, or do you want to choose one of those?
I'll take Meadowlark.
You take Meadowlark.
Mr.
Meadowlark, remember that song? That was a great old song. Let's find out if Meadowlark is up there. We'll begin down at the bottom as usual and reveal the $100 response. Happy as a...
That's what mudlarks are.
That's mudlarks are very happy.
Yep. Happy as a mudlark.
All right. Let's see if Meadowlark is under the $250 number. That's Skylark. That was Brett's answer. Well, you may be right, Mike. Here we go now. Let's slide it and find out if we got a Meadowlark. Yeah!
I would have been the one.
Yeah, yeah.
Very good,
that's
Mike.
Very good judgment.
Thank you.
Very good judgment on your part. Light up the $500. That's it. Thank you very much. Well, you won the $500, and that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000 now. But to collect that, you got to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Richard? All right, here we go. Let's see what happens here. Got your ESP going to Richard?
I hope so.
All right. Boxing blank. Boxing blank. Boxing blank. All right. Have you thought about it, Mike? Think
yeah.
about it now. Look at it. Boxing blank. What do you say to that to match him now?
Ring.
Ring. Boxing ring. That's not a bad answer.
He's
boxing
cute.
Ring is one possibility. Richard, may we see yours, please? And see if he collects the $5,000.
There's a lot, you see. There's boxing gloves, boxing trunk, boxing headgear. Right? I just thought he'd go for the strongest, which would be a boxing match.
Boxing match. Right. All right. You didn't think about that one?
No.
You didn't think about that. All right. Just for that? Pow. No, listen, Mike, you got $600 all together now, and that's not bad. You're going to need another player, so let's welcome Sonia Duplessis. Did you know each other? Sonia, we welcome you, and we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
I'm from Portland, Maine.
Portland, Maine.
I wanted Brett to hear that.
That's where Brett's from.
Where do you live, dear?
Portland, but we're up the road a piece in Windham.
Oh, I know Windham awful well. I was there the last time I was home. I drove by it.
Shut up.
And that's the only way
quickly.
You can go.
Let her talk a little. I want to hear her Maine accent there.
That,
you got a Maine accent?
No, not as bad as really down east.
I see. Where do you live now?
In Windham.
Oh, you live in Windham.
Yeah,
oh.
My husband and my daughter and I are vacationing here.
Uh-huh.
It's a nice place to vacation, too.
But you wouldn't want to live here?
No.
Okay.
I want Maine.
All right, Sonia. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Shall we begin?
Certainly.
Okay. Bing. A or B for Sonia?
B.
B.
Please.
All right. Ready?
I already matched her.
You already matched her?
Well, she said, I don't want to live here. I said, I don't want to live here either. Does that count as a match?
Okay. Now, you got to hear the question first.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The chef said to his wife, I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is your mother was just flattened by a steamroller. The good news is I've made her into a blank. A chef is speaking.
That is a person who cooks.
A chef is one who cooks, right. All right.
I've got that answer. She doesn't have much of a Maine accent, does she?
No, she sure don't have much of a Maine accent.
No pack of family.
Well, I like it here, and I like this country. And I want the camera.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
I spelled mine wrong.
Steamroller, right?
Steamroller. Flattened by a steamroller. Good news is I've made her into a blank. Flattened by a steamroller. Okay, put it in the slot, and away we go. Sonia, the chef, said to his wife, I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is your mother was just flattened by a steamroller. The good news is I've made her into a blank.
Pizza.
Pizza. Anything flat would have been a good answer.
Oh, you well, know my mother.
No.
Yes. What?
I was thinking more in terms of a pancake or a hot cake.
Hot cake and pancake is good. That's another possibility.
Wait till the applause dies down.
Yes. They're on to you, Joey. Did you show it?
Yes.
You have to hold it up
it.
And show it. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Now we'll get rid of it and then come over to you.
Come over to me and do what?
And say, I've got good news and bad news. The good news, I've made her into a pizza, according
you know
to Sonia.
How terrible I feel about letting a fellow maniac down? Good
yes.
gravy, Marie. I said pancake. I was
pancake. That's a good answer. What do you say, sir?
I do. When I get out of my truck in a truck line place,
yeah.
Agnes is.
Right.
They always have, every morning, you have tree pancakes.
Tree pancakes. Okay. I've got good news, bad news. Good news is I've made her into a pizza. What do you say?
No?
I missed the point. I just thought of chef instead of the flat.
Oh, yeah, steamroller.
So I thought, what would you do? Oh. The dead person is all the parts, and you make a casserole?
A casserole.
That's a lucky thought.
Yeah.
She won as a contestant?
She won as a contestant. Well, I remember it was...
But I was nervous.
It was, no, it was a long time ago.
No, I think that was a good answer.
It was a very good answer. What's yours? You want to read it again? All right, good news, bad news. Bad news, mother's flattened my steamroller. Good news is I made her into a...
A meal.
Into a meal.
Yeah. Little hors d'oeuvres.
Yeah.
Casserole.
Right.
Followed by fricassee of finger.
You people really are not listening. Pizza was good. Pancake is good. Crepe Suzette would have been splendid.
Don't give me that crepe.
Any of those things that you've mentioned, Twerpo.
That's what I
happen to be a cook.
Oh, you're thinking about meat.
Well, a human being is made of meat, surely.
Yes, but no, now
unless
wait, but,
you're a vegetarian.
But if you put a steamroller person down there and run over with a steamroller.
They still are meat. Flattened meat.
Flattened meat.
Well, the proof of that is.
With just a dash of clothes.
Oh. The proof of that is that you bring somebody home to meet your mother. You
exactly.
Said, that's it. That proves his point.
Did you write something on your card?
I certainly did.
May
you
we see it?
You invite someone home and say, would you like a pizza mama?
Oh. Pizza mama. So, Sonia, that's one for you. Yours will be along in a moment, but right now, this for you. All right, here we go. Second half of round one. Mike, you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. You rascal. Tarzan say, me study magic, me learn trick never done before. Me not pull rabbit out of hat, me pull blank out of loincloth. Tarzan say, me study magic, me learn trick never done before. Me not pull rabbit out of hat, me pull blank out of loincloth.
Now, is there gonna be a lot of ugliness about that answer?
No, it's all right.
Okay, hon, I'm finished then. And don't say, I've been finished for a long time.
All right, I won't say that.
Sorry.
Yes. Okay. Oh, it's so much fun being in show business. Hello, Mike.
Hello.
Tarzan say, me study magic. Me learn trick never done before. Me not pull rabbit out of hat. Me pull blank out of loincloth.
Monkey.
Monkey. That's okay. Good answer there. Came up with a good one, Joey.
Well, I know, but in thinking, correct?
Yeah, right.
If you say you've learned a new trick, right, and you're dealing with rabbit magic.
Right.
If you didn't pull the rabbit out of your hat, the new trick would have been pulling the rabbit out of your loincloth.
Is that what you wrote?
I'm afraid to answer you now. But I will.
Yes, rabbit, upside down.
Right.
You know, that was exactly my logic, and if
what?
I were playing,
tell
I would
them.
Have said...
Tell them
I'll
so
wait
you
a
can
minute.
Get...
That's a terrific answer. You are a hostile bunch.
Let's get some of them.
They're good people.
Yeah, they're going to start World War III right here. All right. Now, what
they're
do you
terrific
say?
People. Yeah. They make you feel like an illegitimate child at a family reunion.
That's cute.
Yes. I love your hairdo today.
Thank you.
Yes.
And it's all mine. You're going to love this, kids. Get ready to applaud. I said he pulled Jane out of his loincloth.
I know. Hello, Charles.
Hello, darling.
That's half the program. Naturally, the correct answer, I believe.
There's one for old Mike. So the score at this moment is 1-1. Now, Miss Lynn, honey.
Yeah?
Me pulled blank out of loincloth. What do you say to that?
I'm just doing great.
You are?
Banana.
A banana. Me pulled blank out of loincloth.
I've got a defender again.
Yes.
Because a loincloth's very small.
Right.
You can't hide a chimp underneath there.
No.
His legs would be showing from below
That's
the
right.
Now, just imagine. Here's the loincloth.
Right, I see.
There's the chimp.
And the two legs sticking out. It won't work.
But a banana.
But banana's logical.
Superb.
Sure, terrific answer.
Even another banana.
Oh, that's two bananas. Now, there's just so much room under there, Betty. You understand?
Yes. Just reminiscing. Listen, I want to tell you something. I'm not a purist or anything, but a chimp is not a monkey.
It's a primate.
It's an ape.
An ape.
And a monkey is on your back, not under your loincloth. I said a leopard under your loincloth.
A leopard. That would hurt a lot. Holy mackerel. So there we are, 1-1 at the end of round one. We go to round two now and ask Sonia to make her selection.
Be again, please.
Be again. Who does not play? Betty does not play.
Pizza Mama.
Count Dracula said, "Ha! My fan club is dangerous. They never ask for my autograph. What they want is my blank."
They don't ask for my autograph.
My fan club is dangerous. They never ask for my autograph. What they want is my blank.
You got it, sweetheart. Right. In space.
Good. Okay, here we go with Sonia. Count Dracula said, "My fan club is dangerous. They never ask for my autograph. What they want is my blank."
Is he the one that bites your neck?
Yes.
Teeth.
What they want is my teeth.
Teeth. No. Teeth.
You will find out in a minute.
Okay.
Not one tooth will come up here. I will bet anything. What do you say?
I've done a lot of shows. I have never in my life seen an audience come to a studio for spite.
Yeah. Right.
In my whole life, I have never seen this, as long as I have lived. I want them to boo me, because I can think of no other word than blood.
Blood is a good answer. See, when you give a good answer, they let you know.
Go spray something, knock in your mouth, and shut up.
What do you got there?
Don't let it die down, Hans. Blood.
Blood, yeah. Teeth is what she's looking for. Blood is what she gets.
Sonia.
See, Sonia, when he bites you on the neck, he is after your blood.
What about it, Lynn?
I got cocky and said this will be right in little letters. Blood.
Blood. This will be right.
I was wrong.
No, you're right. Well, blood is the answer, the definitive answer. Teeth is all right, but not the best. What do you say?
What do you want?
Blood.
Blood.
That's what I want. That's what I want. You don't play. So there we are, 1-1, middle of round two, coming to you in a moment. But right now, we're coming to you for this. Here we go. Score is 1-1 now. Mike, you've got one question. All you have to do, and you're kind of in the driver's seat here, is match one celebrity, and you will have won your second game. Are you ready for it?
Yes.
One person does not play, and that is Charles N. Reilly. In heaven, when they were giving out noses, ugly Edna thought they said hoses, and that's why she has a blank one. She thought they said hoses, and that's why she has a blank one. Heaven, they were giving out noses. Ugly Edna thought they said hoses, and that's why she has a blank one. All right. Yes, right.
I've been teased all my life. See, that's
where I like. All right. Let's put one in there. That's how we go to one test you.
That's a nice.
Are you ready, Mike? In heaven, when they were giving out noses, ugly Edna thought they said hoses. And that's why she has a blank one.
A rubber one.
A rubber one. Ugly Edna has a rubber nose. What do you say to that, Joey?
We'd have had a good studio once if it hadn't been for the icy roads. Now all over the country they're saying, "Hey, it snowed in Los Angeles." Well, what was it again?
Ugly Edna thought they'd have it said noses. Ugly Edna thought they said hoses. That's why she has a blank one.
You're going to hear booing now like you've never heard.
Oh, no, wait a minute. It might be
good. I said leaky.
A leaky hose. Never heard of a leaky hose?
I don't like
hose.
Those rotten kids in the front. Get them out of here. The one with the sunglasses keeps booing me and it changes her face.
What do you say to that?
Gets awful testy, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
I can't help it.
I just think that's cute when he gets testy like that. A rubber is a terrific answer. Unfortunately, I didn't say that. I said long.
Long. Very good. A long one.
Long.
Long nose. Ugly Edna thought they said hoses, and that's why she has a rubber one, according to Mike there. What do you say?
Well, he's absolutely right.
Rubber! Well, you can thank that little lady there. That was the one. She did it. You had long, and what did you have? You had running. Okay. Sonia, it was a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
Thank you. Pleasure meeting all of you. Bye, Brad.
Good girl, Sonia. We're going to have some gifts for you. Thank you very much, Sonia. And while we're spinning her off, we're going to spin these messages just for you. Thank you. You're all dandy. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time. Match Game 76. Goodbye. But don't get me all smeared up. Let's be gentle because, you know, I can't do this show with lipstick on.
You go too far.
No, just as sweet.
This is foreplay.
Does that mean two others can get into it?
Yeah. All right, my dear, here we go. Oh. Sweet. Very sweet. Let's say hello to our current chef, Mike Eskew, here. Hello, Mike.
Hello.
Mike has won one game. As a matter of fact, you just won the game when we had to quit last time.
Right.
What is that penny doing there?
I found it on the floor.
Oh, there's a dime.
And a dime, too.
Where'd you find it? What floor did you find it?
Right here.
Right down there, yeah. And what's you got in your hand?
I got that at Vegas.
That's a dollar, a silver dollar?
Silver dollar.
Yeah. Is it a good luck symbol for you?
I don't know. It helped yesterday.
Yeah, well, I hope it helps today, Mike.
Oh, I hope so.
I hope so, too. Mike's a coal miner from southern Illinois. And I have felt for many years it was a difficult job, and there ought to be another way of doing it instead of sending the men down 10,000 feet into those terrible black holes. But he likes his work. He's a square peg in a square hole, and he's very happy, and we're very happy to have him. Now, we're going to start with a big money super match here, the audience match, where you could win over $5,000. So come right back and see how Mike does with that. Here we are with old Mike Eskew here from southern Illinois. Benton, Illinois, right?
Right.
Okay, Mike, we'll get right to it now. We polled a recent studio.
Get ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lynn Deerfield, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76,
Gene Rayburn! Hey, Johnny Olson, I'm a dear friend. Nice to have you with us. Let's go over and see who we got today. Welcome, one and all. Nice to see all of your bodies again. I've never seen your body, have I?
Yes, you have.
I have?
Yes,
tell
in 1969.
Me where. In 1969?
I was a contestant on the Match Debuts.
You
in
were
New
a contestant
York,
on the
I
old...
won.
No, how much did you win?
$450.
No kidding.
That's all they'd give. And now... I was a big winner. And Burt Reynolds was my team captain.
Burt Reynolds was your team captain? Who else was on that show?
Don Meredith.
Don Meredith?
I didn't know who they were.
And you didn't know who they were?
You weren't alone in 1969.
Well, she's become an actress.
That's right. You're on The Guiding Light, aren't you? And now you're a big star, and here you are back again. You were on that side at one time, and now you're on this side.
Yeah.
We welcome you. We got to welcome you officially, even though I've seen you before.
Oh, I
you're
forgot
kind of the
Warner
new kid on the
that.
Block.
I know I am.
And the ceremony.
Is that you kiss me?
Yeah.
That was the bad news I was telling you about.
Now listen, you're wearing a lot of lipstick, aren't you?
It's not my fault. I didn't put it on.
You didn't put it on? Your audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Lark, L-A-R-K. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it, $250 if you hook up with the middle one, and $100 for the bottom one. Now, three of our celebrities...
You do her right out of the box.
Okay, excuse me. I didn't mean to sneeze in your face, but they say if you hold it back, you could hurt yourself. Get a hernia or something like that. Anyway, where are we? Oh, yeah. Now, three of our six celebrities are permitted to assist by giving answers here to you.
Brett.
What about Skylark?
Skylark, that's very nice.
Betty.
Betty.
How about Meadowlark?
Meadowlark.
And Richard.
Mudlark.
Mudlark?
Yes, very.
What is a...
It's a mudlark.
A mudlark is a child that goes in the mud to get coins. A film with Alec Guinness. And
really?
Irene Dunne got the Academy Award for playing Queen Victoria. The word mudlarks.
More than I care to...
Now, if he doesn't want it, let him find somebody else to give it.
Now, Mike, you got him. You got Mudlark, Meadowlark, and Skylark. Have you got any other ideas in your head, or do you want to choose one of those?
I'll take Meadowlark.
You take Meadowlark.
You didn't take Mudlark.
Mr. Meadowlark, remember that song? That was a great old song. Let's find out if Meadowlark is up there. We'll begin down at the bottom as usual and reveal the $100 response. Happy as a...
That's what Mudlark talks.
That's Mudlarks are very happy.
Yep. Happy as a Mudlark.
All right. Let's see if Meadowlark is under the $250 number. Skylark. That was Brett's answer. Well, you may be right, Mike. Here we go now. Let's slide it and find out if we got a Meadowlark. Yeah! Very good. Very good.
I thought Sky would have been the one.
Yeah.
Very good,
that's
Mike.
Very good judgment.
Thank you.
Very good judgment on your part. Leg up the $500. That's it. Thank you very much. Well, you won the $500, and that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000 now. But to collect that, you got to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Richard? All right, here we go. Let's see what happens here. Got your ESP going to Richard?
I hope so.
All right. Boxing blank. Boxing blank. Boxing blank. All right, have you thought about it, Mike? Think
yeah.
about it now, look at it. Boxing blank. What do you say to that to match him now?
Ring.
Ring. Boxing ring. That's not a bad answer.
He's
boxing
cute.
Ring is one possibility. Richard, may we see yours, please? And see if he collects the $5,000.
There's a lot, you see. There's boxing gloves, boxing trunk, boxing headgear. Right? I just thought he'd go for the strongest, which would be a boxing match.
Boxing match. Right. All right. You didn't think about that one?
No.
You didn't think about that? All right. Just for that? Pow. No, listen, Mike, you got $600 all together now. That's not bad. You're going to need another player, so let's welcome Sonia Duplessis. You know each other. Sonia, we welcome you, and we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
I'm from Portland, Maine.
Portland, Maine.
I wanted Brett to hear that.
That's where Brett's from.
Where do you live, dear?
Portland, but we're up the road a piece in Windham.
Oh, I know Windham awful well. I was there the last time I was home. I drove by it.
Shut up.
And that's the only way
quickly.
You can go.
Let her talk a little. I want to hear her Maine accent there.
That,
you got a Maine accent?
No, not as bad as really down east.
I see. Where do you live now?
In Windham.
Oh, you live in Windham.
Yeah, my husband and my daughter and I are vacationing here.
Uh-huh.
It's a nice place to vacation, too.
But you wouldn't want to live here?
No.
Okay.
I Maine.
All right, Sonia. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Shall we begin?
Certainly.
Okay. Bing. A or B for Sonia?
B.
B.
Please.
All right. Ready?
I already matched her.
You already matched her?
Well, she said, I don't want to live here. I said, I don't want to live here either. Is that that count as a match?
Okay. No, you got to hear the question first.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The chef said to his wife, I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is your mother was just flattened by a steamroller. The good news is I've made her into a blank. A chef is speaking.
That is a person who cooks.
A chef is one who cooks, right. All right.
I've got that answer. She doesn't have much of a Maine accent, does she?
No, she sure don't have much of a Maine accent.
She's no Quaker family.
Well, I like it here, and I like this country. And I want the camera.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
I spelled mine wrong.
Steamroller, right?
Steamroller. Flattened by a steamroller. Good news is I've made her into a blank. Flattened by a steamroller. Okay, put it in the slot, and away we go. Sonia, the chef.